Corey, you know what time it is. It's time for us to review another movie. This is the fun part. Baseball Mapper boys, Patrick, Corey, you know us. Today we've got another baseball movie review for you. This one's called
Pelotero,
which means ball player in Spanish.
Yeah, Dominican in particular.
Yes. So this movie is a 2012 documentary that focuses on a couple of ball players in the Dominican Republic and kind of follows their story, but really spends a lot of time talking about the experience of trying to become a Major League Baseball player and what that means if you are from the Dominican Republic.
Yeah, it's basically like winning the lottery kind of story.
Yeah.
So this is their ticket out. This is their ticket for their family to have a good life.
The whole family. That's a good point.
So the whole family invests in these kids as young as 8, 9, 10 years old, sends them off to an academy that pays their housing, their food,
the coaching,
all that for years in the hopes that eventually they'll make it to the MLB, get that signing bonus, the coach that housed them for years gets paid.
Finally gets some money, gets a return.
The family gets paid, it all pays off, but what a gamble. You know?
What a gamble. But you know, here's the thing, as small as the Dominican Republic is, it accounts for, in the film, I think they mention roughly 20% of major league players, 20-25%. Right. It is a huge number of players. Like, what country provides more than the Dominican Republic? It's an interesting split. So there is something to be said. And don't think for a minute that Major League Baseball doesn't realize that they've got a cash cow on this island, for
yeah.
sure.
In as much as they had to shut that down, you know? So
much so, they're like, wait, these kids are getting paid a lot.
Right, yeah.
What?
That's too much, actually.
That's too much.
Let's put an end to that.
Are we saying that this documentary doesn't shine the best light on Major League Baseball?
Shocking.
Shocking.
Here we are again.
Yep, another one.
But yeah, so in 2012, they hadn't yet put a cap on bonuses for the Dominican players, which sign at 16 years old, typically.
16 years old, so like not even through with like a high school.
Right.
They already signed, ready to bring them into the minor league system.
Right. So the bonuses are going from $1 million to $4 million and up. And at that point, at some point after the movie comes out, they put a limit on that, and MLB stopped the fun.
Yeah, they're like, wait, this is we can exploit this perhaps a little bit more.
A little more efficiently.
Little bit more. How can we do this so we aren't losing too much? And that's the thing, is that, you know, like we said, this is generational wealth for the people in this film in particular. The extreme poverty you see in the Dominican Republic is really kind of eye-opening, especially if you're not familiar. I've never been there. I've not kind of witnessed that kind of experience. But the players who are being followed in this film, you watch them living in just terrible conditions. And so the hope is, of course, to get out of that.
Yeah, what's interesting is that, you know, once the coach, one of the players in particular, showed really high potential. And so once it was clear he was going to get a large bonus, the coach and the academy moved the whole family into a nice house.
Yeah, agent was on that too. They got an agent who's trying to pull in that money too.
Right. So it's like, all right, so, you know, they moved out of their, you know, kind of
slummy
kind of place and moved into less of a slum.
Yeah.
And that was the first step, you know, to having made it.
Get a nice vehicle. Right. You can't travel around. People will know the ball player. People in the community are going to know the Pelotero because he is the one who has all the promise. He's the one who's going to be leaving this homeland and go finally make it. And like you said, win the lottery is really what it is. July 2nd is a national holiday almost
signing
to them.
Signing day. They mark it on their calendars. Yeah. The whole town has a celebration. Because somebody around them as the golden ticket.
That's a great way to put it. It is very much like the golden ticket, and they are going to be able to escape, to kind of flee this, and everyone can say, oh, I know him, or I saw him play, or whatever. It's a big deal. And you think about it, there are so many Dominican ball players. That's why they have such a strong following when they do make it to Major League Baseball. It is just a huge source of national pride in the Dominican Republic, for sure.
Yeah, it was a really cool story. So this is one where they get you hooked on two players?
Two players.
In particular. and you follow their story. And so I think it's one of those movies that has some appeal beyond, you know, hardcore baseball fans, mm-hmm. because of the, you get drawn into the story.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So I really liked the movie. It was really good.
Yeah, you have there is an elite talent, as Corey alluded to. There is somebody who is actually getting is getting tons of gear, bats, getting a new home, a vehicle, because they are anticipating a huge bonus for this player. He's going to make something for sure. Might even break records. But you find out a lot about what that's like. And again, we've talked about how it's kind of a black eye on MLB. There's even a team in this movie that really winds up looking kind of dirty, does some dirty underhanded dealing with its foreign scouts that are there trying to cherry pick these players and get them before another team can. How can I get him to sign with our team? And some underhanded dealing really kind of goes on. Yeah. Doesn't look good.
And the leverage there for that particular dirty scout is that Dominicans in particular have a history of lying about their age, mm-hmm. because of the 16-year like sort of cutoff.
That's your cutoff. 16 in the Dominican Republic. It's like if you're older than that, you're no good.
Right.
It's too late, which is ridiculous.
Right. So it's similar in like for college ball players. If you go to college, you have to stay for 3 years, and if you're any good, you get drafted after your third year. And then if you like your contract offer, you sign and you finish college later or whatever. But, you know, if you don't like your offer, you don't get drafted, you go back to college another year and you got another chance. It's just less likely.
Yeah.
Your contract offer is almost for sure to be less after your senior year, because what are you going to do? You got no more college left. So you sort of have to take what you're offered.
Same way with the Dominican ball players. If it's past 16, that was the prime age.
Right.
You're not going to get the massive contract. And so, of course, you have this incentive to lie to make yourself be younger, faking birth certificates and things like that. And that really comes up quite a bit in this film, is that there's a fear that the Major League Baseball is going to give bonus money to a player who isn't really who they say they are or how old they are.
Yeah, I think there's examples of that for several MLB ball players.
Absolutely.
And, you know, whether that really matters or not, it's not clear
if they're good or not, but I guess it's starting off on the wrong foot by lying, I guess.
So if they do get caught lying, they're suspended for a year, which really hurts their bonus opportunity the next year and all that. So,
making it better for them to be able to leave and pay their debt to the academy and all, get them the nice house for their family.
Right. Yeah, right. That's a leverage these scouts have is, you know, come on, sign with us for, you know, a lot less than you probably should. And, you know, we're going to overlook all that stuff, you know.
Right.
So it's shady. And, you know, it's just not a good look for MLB, I don't think.
Yeah, but it's fascinating when so many of the MLB stars that we even watch today hail from that country. Why not find out what it's like for them? Why is it so important to come to America and play for Major League Baseball? Why are they willing to do it if it's not the best situation? Pelotero, man, Corey mentioned, this has got general appeal for everybody. There's some edge of your seat waiting to find out, how is this going to work? What are we going to find out next?
I'm not sure I can say it right. John
Leguizamo.
Yeah,
narrates
it. Yeah. So it's definitely a good movie.
It's worth checking out.
I think the only place you can watch right now is Amazon Prime for a rental fee. It used to be on Netflix, not anymore. So
we'll include that link in the comments. Go ahead, give it a spin. Check it out, see what you think, and make sure you're following us at Baseballmapper on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, anywhere you can see this. You know we're going to get another review for you soon. Hopefully we'll find something as good as Pelotero. Until next time.